Hi there, everyone. My name is Matt Elman.
Hi, and I'm Peter Lucantoni.
And together we are the authors of this new book, From Teacher to Trainer. And to introduce the book and some of the ideas that we write about in it, I'm going to ask Peter five questions about teacher training. Are you ready, Peter?
I'm ready. Fire away.
All right, let's go. So question one, what first sparked your interest in teacher training?
I don't think an interest was sparked. I think I was thrown in at the deep end. I think that's true of lots of trainers. When I was working in the Middle East, I was asked to fill in for a trainer on a CELTA course who wasn't available. Somebody said, Peter, would you do a language awareness session on conditionals? So I said, yeah, and I did it. So it wasn't really a conscious decision, I want to be a trainer. It was just, I got thrown in at the deep end, as so many of us have had the same experience. What about you?
Well, for me, it came out of an interest in teaching and just running groups with teachers, like reading groups and action research groups. But I guess it was similar in your case that you must have been a good teacher, or at least demonstrated an interest in teaching, and that's why they asked you.
Far be it from me to say I was a good teacher, but yeah, hopefully I was doing something right. Yeah.
Hopefully. All right. And then as you started becoming a trainer, what was your biggest challenge?
I think two challenges, actually. The first one was confidence, not feeling confident about what I was doing, because I was actually quite young when this happened. And, a lot of the people around me, people I was training were older than me, more experienced. So I think that was one challenge. But the other challenge, and I think it's a challenge which all trainers face nowadays, and a question I'm often asked when I'm working with new trainers, is about materials and resources. It's not like teaching where there's X number of course books available and methodology books available. For training, there's very few resources actually available. So that was the second big challenge that I faced when I started.
Yeah,
and I guess
yeah,
the same for you.
Yeah, very much so. It was kind of hard to know if I was doing it right. And I had a few other trainers around to ask, but they kind of were basing their answers on their own experience rather than on anything that they'd read or any kind of syllabus or curriculum for teacher trainers. So that was a challenge. And the other thing was having to kind of generate opportunities for training myself, because they didn't kind of fall into my lap. So you have to be quite self-motivated, I think. All right, question three. What has been your most rewarding training experience? Apart from working with me, obviously.
Yeah, apart from working with you. I've had many, but I have very, very specific of being in Yemen many, many years ago, in a university auditorium, and there was probably 700-800 teachers in there, and there was no electricity. So the best laid plans, the PowerPoint and the microphone, nothing worked, but I had to perform. And I did, as any trainer would. You do your best, but I just remember being faced with this mass of people, like being in a football stadium, but not really being able to reach them because my voice just couldn't project in such a vast space. And I can't remember specifics, but I know it was hot and everybody was sweating, but we did it, and everybody clapped at the end and I clapped, and it was quite an amazing experience, but not one that I'd like to repeat.
No, it sounds sounds memorable though, sure. I think for me the most memorable ones tend to be when you're training the same group over an extended period. because then you get to know them, of course, but you also I think you would probably end up having a lot more impact on their teaching. And I was lucky enough to go to Western Ukraine a couple of years ago and do a week with teachers there. So that's probably been the most rewarding one for me.
But how often does that happen?
Less so now, of course, with the pandemic. A couple of times a year, to 2-3 times a year, perhaps. And the rest of the time it's online stuff or kind of one-off visits.
Yeah.
Question 4, why did you feel the need to write the book?
This book. Oh, that book. The other book, that book. it wasn't my initial idea. Somebody, one of our colleagues, came to me with a proposal for a similar book and asked me to review the proposal. And I wasn't very positive about the review. So this colleague turned around and said, well, would you like to have a go at it? And at the time, I was very heavily involved in the Cambridge Train the Trainer course that we still deliver. I decided that I'd like to sort of put into a book many of the elements that I'd discovered and learned on the Train the Trainer course, at which point I approached you. I think we were at a sales conference in Eastern Europe somewhere in December. Bucharest, Budapest?
Possibly,
can't remember, it was somewhere like that. And obviously you agreed, and it went from there. And I think without your input, it wouldn't be as wonderful as it actually is. I don't think I could have done as good a job as you've done on it. So thank you very much.
Oh, that's kind of you. Thanks, Peter. Yeah, I mean, for me, it was about filling that gap that I'd experienced when I started training and had nothing really to draw upon and nothing to turn to and no kind of frameworks or kind of scaffolding to get started in teacher training. So so that was important. And also trying to bring some kind of evidence base to teacher training, and instead of having it just be this kind of set of activities or tricks or whatever passed down from one trainer to another. All right, and final question, what's your top piece of advice for new teacher trainers?
I think there's only one piece of advice for new teacher trainers, and that's get out there and do it. Because, you know, whether you've read our book or done the Train the Trainer course or read this bit of research or that bit of research, until you actually get out there and do it, it makes much sense. And I think that's probably, you know, you and I are lucky because, you know, we're employed as trainers, so we have endless opportunities. But I think most of the people that we train are teachers who want to be trainers but actually don't have the opportunities to do much training, you know, putting things into practice and learning by doing. So my one and only tip really is, you know, now you've done the course, now you've read the book, go and do it, because that's the way you'll become better, you know, become a better trainer, a more effective trainer, a more impactful trainer. What about you?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that speaks, of course, to what I was saying before about being self-motivated and kind of creating your own opportunities. And I think maybe my tip would be to draw on all your experience as a teacher. And hopefully as a teacher, you're looking at your classroom and solving problems, trying to get better. And that's what a lot of teacher training is about. It's about solving problems and helping others get better, helping them reach a point where they can solve their own problems as teachers. So if you're doing that as a teacher, you're kind of on the right path already.
Agreed. Yep.
Good stuff. All right, thanks, Peter. It's been very enjoyable. Just to remind everybody, From Teacher to Trainer is out in all good bookshops now, and if you want to find out more about professional learning resources from Cambridge University Press, you can go to cambridge.org/PLD. That's all from me. Thanks, everyone, and bye for now.
Bye, everybody.